Class 4 computer. Class 4 computer. Today we are going to start a new chapter. That is welcome to internet. Internet is such a thing that is known by all, right? Internet is such a thing that is known by all, whether it is a kid or a youngster or an adult, or you say a aged man. Everybody knows internet, and today we are going to learn about internet. As you already know that internet is only one thing which has been there as a blessing. Internet is only one thing which has been there as a blessing. During the pandemic, we are connected to each other and carry on with all our routine, our studies, our work, everything, right? So we should be grateful to internet, and we should be thankful to God that the God has given us one way by which we are connected to each other, by staying in our homes safe and continuing our studies, right? So I hope you all are good in health, stay safe and stay home. Let's get started with the following chapter. Welcome to internet. There are thousands of things we are going to learn about internet. There are so many things about internet that it is endless study. But whatever thing is important according to your standard, today I'm going to tell you about everything, that how internet is useful, how not, and what is internet, and so on. So pay attention to the following chapter, because this is really very interesting and I hope you love this chapter. So let's get started with the chapter. Welcome to internet. There are thousands of computers around the world. All these computers are linked together. To share information. The information exchange became easy in the form of emails and computer network. So there are thousands of computers around our whole world. Now there is something which is linked together with thousands of computer. While you're staying anywhere in the world, you can send anything to anyone around the world. This is happening with the help of the emails and the computer network which we are having. It is happening with the help of that. So today we are going to learn that what is computer network. You're going to learn about the computer network in the next slide. So again, I'm telling you that there are thousands of computers around the world, and all these computers are linked to share information, and this information exchange become easy in the form of sending something in the form of emails and computer network. So let's see what are computer networks in the next slide. सो कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क, कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क इज इंटरकनेक्टिंग टू और मोर कंप्यूटर्स टुगेदर फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ शेयरिंग रिसोर्सेज एंड इंफॉर्मेशन. सो व्हाट इज रिटन इन योर बुक दैट व्हाट इज द कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क, इट इज इंटरकनेक्टिंग टू और मोर कंप्यूटर्स टुगेदर फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ शेयरिंग resources and information, whatever resources we want to share or whatever information we want to share, we can share with the help of computer network. Now let us study it briefly, that what is a computer network. Okay, what is a computer network and what are the advantages and disadvantages of computer network. So first of all, computer network is a group of computers. Okay, it is a group of computers that use a common communication protocols, that use a common set of communication protocols, okay, over digital interconnection. It is done over digital interconnection. There are having some common set of protocols, communication protocols, which is done over digital interconnection for the purpose of sharing resources located on or provided by network nodes. Okay, so what is computer network? It is a group of computers that use a set of common communication protocols or over digital interconnections for the purpose of sharing resources which is located on or provided by computer, different computer nodes. So this is computer network. So in your book it is written, a computer network is interconnecting two or more computers together for the purpose of sharing resources and information. The meaning of these two are same, that means there are different computers which are connected to each other by a common set of communication protocol which is done over digital media or digital interconnection for sharing resources and information. It is located on or provided by a network nodes. It is done with the help of a network nodes. So this is the work of a computer network. Now we are going to learn that, see, everything is having advantages and disadvantages. Means everything is somewhere good and somewhere bad. So we should always take the good part. Okay. But then also we should know that what are the bad parts about it. And we should be careful about it. So we are going to know that what is networks, computer networks advantages and disadvantages in the following points. So first of all, we should always think positive. So we are going to see the positive way of this. That means we are learning the advantages of computer network first. So sharing devices such as printers saves money. Now when you want to share something, you want to take out the printer, you can connect printers in the computer. With the help of the internet, you can take out the printings, and which saves a lot of money. If you go out and do, the printing cost a huge amount, so which saves a lot of money. Then site software licenses are likely to be cheaper than buying several standalone licenses. So site software licenses are likely to be cheaper than buying several standalone licenses. File can be easily shared between users. The files can be easily shared between the users. Network users can communicate by email and instant messenger. Network users can communicate easily by the help of email and instant messenger. Data is easy to backup. All the data is stored on the file server. So data is easy to backup. All the data is stored on the file server. So these were the advantages. Now, what are the disadvantages of computer network? Purchasing the network, that is cabling and file servers, can be expensive. So you know that when we are recharging our data, it is expensive. Why it is expensive? Because the demand has increases. The demand of internet has increases in a tone. When it was not such a demandable thing, then the internet price was very low. Now everyone knows that every person needs internet. In every home, there are 2 or 3 internet connections. So it is very important. So the recharge is also expensive. When there is a demand, the seller knows. If I will increase the price also, the users will come and buy, because it is our daily lifestyle. Because we need it. And if we don't need it, then also we want it. Because we cannot stay without internet nowadays. So this is somewhere one disadvantage. Now viruses can be spread to other computers throughout a computer network. With the help of a computer network, what happens? The viruses are spreading from one computer to another computer network. The virus can spread. Okay. And the last one is, there are actually many more. There is a danger of hacking, particularly with wide area networks. Now when internet is connected to a wide range, okay, when it is connected to a wide range, what happens? There is a risk of hacking. Nowadays there are many cases of hacking, that someone has hacked someone's account or something, hacked someone's phone. So this is done with the help of an internet. With the help of the internet, this is done. So somewhere this is a very big disadvantage, and it is a danger also. It is dangerous for hacking also. Okay, so these were the some disadvantages and advantages of computer network. Now let's learn about the next topic. Internet and its users. So, internet and its users. Internet is the worldwide network of networks. It is a worldwide network of networks. Means this is a network of networks. It is connected. That connects millions of computers through communication channels. It connects millions of computers through communication channels like copper wire, fiber optic cables, and wireless connections. So it is done through copper wires, fiber optic cables, and wireless connection. It is a repository that provides huge information. So this is about what it is written in your book. Now, internet. Actually, what is an internet? It is a global network, okay? It is a global network providing variety of information and communicating facilities. Okay, so it provides variety of information and communicating facilities. Using and costing of interconnected network, and it is costing of interconnected networks. Using standardized communication protocols. Using standardized communication protocols. It is a network, vast network that connects computers all over the world. It is a network, vast network that connects computer all over the world. Through internet, people can share information and communicate from anywhere with an internet connection. Okay, so with the help of internet, you know what are the uses you are using now. With the help of internet only, we are able to provide you education right during this pandemic. So we should be grateful to God, and we should always think that it is a blessing that wherever we are able to take our education so beautifully. There is nothing to be disappointed. So we should be very happy that wherever we are continuing to get our education. Tech facts. So what does this tech fact says? That robot Ecan and Windcurve, robot Ecan and Windcurve were considered as key inventors of internet after inventing TCP or IP protocol. So Robert Ecan and Windcurve were considered as a key inventors of internet after inventing TCP or IP protocol. Now see, this is very important, that what are the uses of internet? What are the uses of internet? The internet is a fantastic place to search information related to homework or any project. So internet is a fantastic place to search information related to homework or any project. It is a medium that makes communication easy by means of email, blogs, social networking sites, forums, chats, and video conferencing. So it is a medium that makes communication easy by the means of email, blogs, social networking sites, forums, chats, and video conferencing. It helps to perform e-commerce, that is buy or sell any product. It acts as an entertainment medium. That is online games, movies, etc. Easy banking operations in a secured way. Making the examination process easy by declaring results online. Provides up-to-date information in all the areas. So these are the portion which we have read today, that what is computer network, what are the advantages and disadvantages of computer network, and we have also learned about the internet inventors, key inventors of internet, then users of internet. So these were the following things which we have learned. So go through the chapter very well, okay, and practice all the things whatever we have done. You have to go through the chapter very well. Okay, now the last chapter which we have read, that is logo. Okay, logo, commands and its procedure. The last chapter which we have read. Over there, logo, what is the full form of logo? So please note it down. The full form of logo, please note it down. The full form of logo. The full form of logo is language of graphics oriented. Language of graphics oriented. So this is the full form of logo. It is very important. I have forgotten to say you in the previous class. So I am just telling you, so note it down in your copy. The full form of logo is language of graphics oriented. Till then, thank you.